NepalNews.com. News from Nepal, as it happens.
विश्वमा सशस्त्र द्वन्द्वका कारण पीड़ित भएका महिलाहरूको समस्या अभिलेखीकरण गर्न नेपालमा दुई हप्ते तालिम कार्यक्रमको आयोजना गरिँदैछ। उक्त तालिम कार्यक्रममा सहभागी जनाउन विभिन्न देशबाट आउनुभएका प्रतिनिधिहरूलाई समस्त महिलाहरूको अधिकार सुनिश्चित गर्न के कस्ता नीति तर्जुमा गर्नुपर्छ भनेर हामीले सोधेका थियौँ।
I think there are various policies that are required both at international, national and at local level, and the kinds of policies that are required are those that protect women's rights, protect them from violence, allow them to own property, allow them to earn a living, and I think in the situations of violent conflict we need the kinds of instruments that recognize the trauma that women experience during armed conflict, and also the kind of trauma, not only physical trauma, but social and economic trauma, because women tend to be the ones who are displaced, the ones who look after families and make a living within situations of extreme deprivation. So
as an African woman, I think that we should be able to protect the women who are defending the rights of other women. So I think there should be, first of all, protection mechanisms like them having identity cards, because at times when they go on the streets, they could be mistaken for opposition parties, but they are fighting and they are trying to address women human rights, which are universal and which don't only apply to Nepalese women, but also to men and children as well. So there should be, first of all, a policy to protect them and have identity cards so that they are not mistaken for the enemy.
Education is mandatory. Because without education, if the mindset is not there, if awareness is not there, so how can they work and how can they be a contributing member of the society? And we need to work for peace in this world. And peace cannot be brought without awareness, without understanding, and without equality and ensuring rights. Because if you don't ensure rights to someone, then if there is discrimination and injustice to someone, then in suffocation he or she can opt for something that is violence or that is militancy, and that is the essence or crux of this program.
Well, the kind of policy we need to ensure women's rights is to involve women in the implementation of policies concerning their own problems, their own the issues related to women. So if women are not involved, I think that the government will miss something, because women alone can talk about the problem they are coming across. So nobody else apart them can talk about their own experiences. So we need women to take these issues to the government.
अधिकार सुनिश्चित गर्नको लागि सबभन्दा पहिले त अब संविधान नै महिला अधिकार सुनिश्चित गर्ने खालको हुनुपर्छ, होइन? अब त्यसमा खास गरी यातनामुक्त जीवन बाँच्न पाउने अधिकार, हिंसा पीडित महिलाहरूलाई चाहिँ क्षतिपूर्तिको अधिकार, यी कुराहरू चाहिँ मौलिक हकमै सम्बोधित हुनुपर्छ एउटा कुरा। अर्को कुरा, सरकारबाट एकदमै व्यापक रूपमा चाहिँ समुदाय स्तरदेखि व्यवहार परिवर्तनका कुराहरू चाहिँ अगाडि ल्याउनुपर्छ, होइन भनेदेखि संविधानले मात्रै या कानुनले मात्रै नेपालमा महिला अधिकार सुनिश्चित हुन सक्दैन।
There has been a lot of problems, and I think the worst affected are the women. So what I think at the moment we need is our policies that are meant for the development of women, where socio-economic and psychological development of women can take place, because these are the worst affected areas. You see, because of this abnormal conditions, women in Kashmir are facing a lot of psychological problems. They are undergoing stress, trauma, tensions, because their everyday lives are full of so much uncertainty and fear. So we need programs that can tailor these into women's lives, and generally these women are not aware of what is going on in their lives. You know, they don't understand these are normal symptoms to abnormal situation.
द्वन्द्वबाट प्रभावित तथा समस्त महिलाहरूको अधिकार सुनिश्चित गर्न विभिन्न प्रतिनिधिहरूले दिनुभएको सुझाव यति नै।
NepalNews.com